But we have a caller in here. I'm just going to try and get him on. Salaam alaikum. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Salaam alaikum. Salaam alaikum. You're live with us here on the Rafida Roundtable. Thank you for calling. Please introduce yourself, your name, and your question.
Yeah, my name is Imran, and I'm calling you from India, Delhi.
MashaAllah. Welcome, brother Imran. How are you doing? Inshallah, you're well and in good health and iman.
Thank you so much.
Father, go ahead.
I always try to watch your videos on YouTube, and let me tell you that you guys are doing a fantastic job.
Thank you.
May Allah reward you, brother. May Allah bless you. We appreciate your support. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Recently, I just saw the new video you done on the attack on Fatima Al-Zahra, peace be upon her and her family.
Salam Allah alayha.
What I saw in comment section, many Sunni brothers were saying that if this has happened, then it means the Imam Ali was a coward in Azabillah.
Imam Ali, go ahead.
So I just want you people to clarify this for the viewers, that where was Imam Ali alayhi salam? Why didn't he protect his family?
Yes. So just so I can make sure I'm understanding, the line isn't as clear as I'd hope, but I think it's clear enough, inshallah. A lot of the so-called Sunnis, and I believe you're saying that you read some people that are saying that if this is the case, then Imam Ali is a coward, according to what we're saying.
Yeah.
Which is a common your question's clear, so who wants to take this question? Go ahead, David, go ahead.
So yeah, first of all, he was there.
Firstly, sorry, thank you for your question, brother. Please stay on the line. If you have any comments or anything to follow up with brother David, you can do that. Sorry, David.
Thank you. Bye. So first of all, the Imam Ali alayhi salam, he was there, because they always say he not got of his house, he was not there, he was coward. I don't think they believe he was coward, but they use this argument to say all the narrative we use is fake.
Yeah,
they used to say that. First of all, he was there, and he hit Omar on his nose and his neck, which is
he hit him.
Yeah, he hit him. Yes. Of course.
Even. Yeah.
He hit him. That's something, unfortunately, which is not well known by Shia, because a lot of them, they don't use their own source, because the source for this you can find in Sulaim ibn Qais, the book.
Yeah.
Everything is there. If you want to have, he was there.
Just to add on to Brother David, Amir al-Mu'min was there in the house. Moments after Umar attacked Fatima alayhi salam. Moments, just seconds. It was a matter of seconds. It wasn't a matter of time and so on. It was a matter of seconds. As soon as Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam heard the sarkha of Fatima, the scream of Fatima, that there's a man in the house, that Umar attacked her in her house, Amir al-Mu'mineen kharaja kallayth al-ghadban. He came like an angry lion, like a furious lion. He went out defending Fatima alayhi salam. He grabbed Umar from the top of his garments, from here. He grabbed him like this, from the top of his garments. Picked him up and hurled him on the ground, like this. Smashed him on the ground. Sat on his chest. First, stepped on his face. He stepped on his face, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Stepped on his nose. Showed him his place. Stepped on his face. Sat on his chest. And he was going to kill him, as the narration states.
Sorry, Brother Ali. Someone in the chat, I know I don't want to cut David off for too long, but someone is commenting saying, Sulaim ibn Qais al-Hilali's fabricated book. This is something I hear a lot, that this is a fabricate. I hear this from the Shia as well, as heartbreaking as that can be.
Yeah.
Do you want to comment briefly before back to David? Sorry, David, just because I saw this comment is very, very important.
Sulaim ibn Qais al-Hilali is a fabricated book.
Because, Brother Ali, what they say, and actually another Twitter question came regarding this topic, that's why I brought it up. They're saying that this situation or this story, according to the Shia, cannot be used because apparently there's weakness in the chain. And this comment on YouTube is saying that the book is fabricated. So even according to you, Shia, this story, you cannot take it. And
can you display the comments?
Yeah. So bring this comment up, Subhan, as well. There's a tweet that I'll
show. Like the last two tweets. The last two comments on you.
No, sorry, just to bring the tweet up. Sorry,
just to finish what I was saying.
Go ahead, and Subhan can bring the tweet up.
Qais al-Hilali. Knowing that this narration is not only in Kitab Salim, yani the narrations of the attack on Fatima is not only in Kitab Salim. We'll discuss that after I see the question, inshallah. Amir al-Mu'mineen grabbed Umar from the top of his garments, and the narration states his eyes were so red as if it was blood in his eyes, out of the furiosity, out of the anger of what's happened. As soon as he heard the scream of Fatima alayhi salam, he got up, took Umar from the top of his garments, hurled him on the ground, stepped on his face, sat on his chest, and Amir al-Mu'mineen sat on his chest. He was he was going to kill him, but he did not, fulfilling by that the command of the Prophet, peace be upon him. We should remember that the Prophet, peace be upon him, commanded Amir al-Mu'mineen that if you don't have 40 men, you do not have permission to rise. Though he defended Fatima alayhi salam. Not like Uthman ibn Affan, as reporters say, that some of the killers of Uthman ibn Affan entered the house of Uthman ibn Affan, knocked him down, beat him up, roughed him up a little bit, and he was left blooded. And his wife, Naila bintul Farafisa. Yeah, Naila bintul Farafisa. She came defending Uthman ibn Affan. As she dropped herself for Uthman ibn Affan, one of the killers of Uthman ibn Affan, one of the muqtahimeen, those who entered his house, cut her fingers, and she left, holding her fingers like this. She ran away. And when that happened, that killer, although we don't necessarily praise him, by the way, we don't praise all the killers of Uthman ibn Affan, but just to make my points, that killer specifically slapped the back of Naila, disrespecting her and disrespecting Uthman when he was alive. Uthman was alive. He was just beat up, roughed up, punched up, you know. Why didn't he defend his wife? No. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam defended Fatima alayhi salam, the daughter of the Prophet, unlike your companion, who is, according to you, better than Amir al-Mu'mineen, Uthman ibn Affan, who watched his wife get assaulted by another man and did nothing. That should answer the question, inshallah.
Ahsan, so sorry because I was distracted. You didn't address the Kitab Sulaim thing yet.
Yeah, can I just read it, please?
Would you mind if we finish David first and we'll come to that?
The question is finished. Just if you want more detail, you can go to the link of... We have the link in Al-Qatra in English.
Right.
Which is the...
What's the article called?
The article called... I don't have it in front of me, but there's an article which clearly... The same question, exactly the same question.
Yeah.
And we got all of the details about that.
Right. If you can, David, try to find an article. We'll throw it in after if you can find it. There's nothing to add from your side, David, huh?
No, it's okay.
Brother Sahil, does that answer your question? Did you have any follow-up, any other question, or is that all? I hope he's still with us.
Is he?
No, the phone's cut. Sorry.
No, it's good.
All right. I hope that answered your question, Brother Sahil. And great question, brilliant question. I always hear that claim. And even the YouTuber, the YouTube comment... who claimed that the book is fabricated. Yes. I think Brother Ali will address that question.
Sure.
Before we do, sorry, I just realized, I promised the YouTube chat that we're going to address their questions because there's a lot coming through. And then we'll come back to Kitab Sulaim's point about it being fabricated.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.